Insomma, l'Omar. Good morning, Rabotai. Today is Sunday in the Seder of Parashat Beshallah, which means this coming Shabbat will be Shabbat Shira. That's the Shabbat in which we will be singing Az Yashir Moshe during the reading of the Torah. It means reading the Shira. And then following Shabbat, on Tuesday we will have to be Shabbat. But today, you know, yesterday was Dalet Shevat, which is the Hilulah of Baba Saleh. I thought maybe it would be a good idea if I say a few words in English regarding Baba Saleh. Who is Baba Saleh? Why his reputation has been growing from year to year, especially that he passed away. I think it is important that on the day, or at least even though the day is yesterday, Shabbat, because on Shabbat what can you do? Normally thousands and tens of thousands of people, they go to the grave of Baba Saleh in Netivot, Eretz Israel. But since it is the closest, today is the closest to the day which to yesterday, that's why we will say today a few things about Baba Saleh. Number one, what is his real name? Was his name Baba Saleh? No. Baba Saleh is a nickname, which means Baba in Arabic means the master, the father. Saleh means the one who prays, or prayer, the master of prayer, or the father of prayer. Why did he gain such a beautiful nickname? What was his real name? His real name was Rabbi Israel Abu Hatzira. Was Rabbi Israel Abu Hatzira his real name? Not even that, because his real name, from his family name, was in fact Elbaz. His great-grandfather was Rabbeinu Shemuel Elbaz, alav shalom, a tzaddik gadol. He was the father of Rabbi Yaakov Abu Hatzira, who is the grandfather of Baba Saleh. And Rabbi Yaakov Abu Hatzira is again a name of reputation that is abnormal. Many books were written about Rabbi Yaakov Abu Hatzira as a man, as a miracle maker, through his prayers. But since we deal now with Baba Saleh, who also gained the tremendous reputation of a person whose prayer was many times, I mean, what do I mean by many times? Well, most of the time, his prayer was accepted. How do we know that? From the testimony of hundreds of thousands of people. You know, when everyone has his story, everyone has kind of some kind of miracle that happened to his life. But that's not something to even talk about, because everyone to himself. But Baba Saleh has succeeded to help thousands of thousands upon people with his prayers, in accordance with the faith and belief of the people. Lo and behold, hundreds of thousands became believers in this tzaddik. When we say you believe in a tzaddik, that does not mean you believe in him as a deity, chas v'shalom, God forbid. We don't have any intermediaries like the other religions have. We have Hashem himself. We can turn to Hashem himself if you know how to pray. However, Hashem is allowing us to go through tzaddikim. I mean, since we regard ourselves as small, humbly talking, we need someone who is, in our eyes, represents sanctity, purity of character, wisdom of Torah, wisdom of Kabbalah, and the Jewish people believes that through people like this, our prayer is being transported, carried by them, through their prayer, through their beracha. And that's how we believe, Am Yisrael believes, that the prayer could attain great heights. And that's the reason, that's how matters like this develop. So, for example, the Chabad community believed so much in the Rebbe, the Lubavitcher Rebbe, that the Lubavitcher Rebbe became extraordinarily a man of great reputation as a great tzaddik. And indeed, his blessing counted. His blessing, as testified by hundreds of thousands of people. In fact, I heard once a certain rabbi who explained this phenomenon in such a way. He says, the reason why there was power in the bracha of the Lubavitcher Rebbe, for example, is because of the number of people who believed in that bracha. When you have so many people who believe in it, then the bracha becomes a tremendous source of power. You understand? And that's the point. Baba Saleh, the Sephardic counterpart, as you know, he was born in Morocco, in the area of that we call the Tafilalet in Morocco. And there he grew to be a man of sanctity. He was a saint. There are so many stories about him. And as we said before, the reason why he is called Baba Saleh, because even the name Rabbi Israel Abu Chatzira, which is his name, in fact was changed. The name Abu Chatzira, which means in Hebrew the father of the mat. Chatzira in Arabic, Hasera. That said, a mat upon which people used to sit on the floor. It's made of straw. So there is a story that some say Rabbi Yaakov Abu Chatzira himself, some say Rabbi Shmuel Alav Shalom Elbaz. This is the father of Rabbi Yaakov Abu Chatzira. That one day, he wanted to cross the ocean to go somewhere else, maybe to Eretz Israel. And there was no possibility to do it. And then all he did was, according to the legend, he put his mat on the surface of the ocean, of the water, and it carried him by saying the name Shema Meforash. He was capable of crossing the ocean. That's a legend. And that's how from the name Elbaz, they changed it to Abu Chatzira, the master of the mat. You know, like the stories, Chas v'shalom, I cannot liken it to any of the stories of the thousand nights and one night. When you know about those people who used to fly on a flying rug. You know, the stories of flying rugs. Chas v'shalom here, apparently it's a true story. And that's how the family became Abu Chatzira. And then some great people came out from it, from this great family. Rabbi Yaakov Abu Chatzira, a real angel of God. And then Baba Saleh in our days. So now Baba Saleh gained his title because he prayed. He prayed for people. People came to him and believed in his prayer. And according to what it says in so many books were written about the miracles that happened because of the bracha of Baba Saleh. And a reputation like this does not come for nothing. You have to understand that. You have to understand that among the Jewish people, if somebody is false, even if you make up so many stories, they will fade. They will disappear. With the time, they will never hear any more about it. But when you see something that's becoming tangible day after day, that's becoming solid, that despite the fact that Baba Saleh himself passed away, but now the stories go on, you must understand that there is definitely at least a certain amount of those stories that happen to be true. I had a discussion with his son, Baba Baruch, Rabbi Baruch, the son of Baba Saleh, and he told me himself that he is amazed from the stories that he himself reads about his father. But he says, I assure you that a large part of those stories is true. Now, that doesn't mean that the rest is not true. But sometimes, because we know that the usual tendency of the people is to exaggerate, So maybe, because even in the Talmud we find exaggerations. I mean, you could check even the Gemara in Masichet Arachin that we are studying today. There is a certain story in which it says the Gemara does testify to the fact, Amar Rav Nachman Bar Yitzchak Matnita Guzma, which means that story is only an exaggeration. It is possible that also in the stories of a tzaddik like Baba Saleh or any other tzaddik, there are always a few exaggerations. But as we say in French, il n'y a jamais de feu sans fumée. There is never fire without smoke. At least there is smoke. Something happened. I mean, I can tell you many stories. There is one story really that is true. It is so extraordinary that people, if they hear it, they will not believe in it. But since it was written in books, how can you say it's not written when they are saying that it happened right in a few years ago? And not only that, there is a whole yeshiva that the yeshiva HaNegev. Yeshiva HaNegev in Netivot is one of the greatest yeshivot in the whole world and in Eretz Israel. I know the Rosh Yeshiva, Rabbi Sachar Meir, extraordinary rabbi. He used to be the Rosh Yeshiva of Tangier, long time ago, before I went to Tangier, in Morocco. The Yeshiva of Tangier, Etz Chaim. So, let me tell you the story at least. There is a soldier, a Jewish, an Israeli soldier, that has been wounded. And his legs, the doctors decided that they should cut off his legs, because they realized that gangrene was in progress, and now if they don't amputate his legs, he will die. The boy, coming from Moroccan origin, could not tolerate the idea that his legs will be cut off. And he begged his parents to take him from the hospital. But the parents know that the doctor said that if they don't cut your legs, you will die. In a matter of weeks, gangrene does not forgive. But he kept begging and begging. One of the family members, when he heard this, he said, you know what? Let's take him, you know, in secrecy, of course, in the middle of the night, because the doctors will not let them take him. And he said, you know what? It's now the middle of the night. Let's take him directly to Baba Saleh. The problem is that the young man was not religious at all, was not Shomer Shabbat. He did not do the mitzvot, was not Shomer mitzvot. Nevertheless, since he is the one who is suffering, he said, yes. They took him to Netivot. When they arrived there, it was already 5 o'clock in the morning. Baba Saleh was ready for his prayers of the morning. They entered with the young man, you know, in the chair. They told the Baba Saleh, please, he came for your bracha, maybe if you can pray for him. He heard the case, and when he heard the case, he turns to the young soldier and he said to him, do you keep the mitzvot? The young man says, no, I don't. I'm not a religious man. You don't keep Shabbat? He even said in Arabic, he said, Shale. I mean, he said, what kind of this? And you don't keep Shabbat? What are you? You're crazy? I don't keep Shabbat. You don't put tefillin every day? No, I don't put tefillin every day, he said. So the rabbi said, if it was Rabbi Mechluf Abu Hatzir, I would say, Ksufs. he would throw at him an insult. So he said to him, and if you are cured, would you become Shomer Shabbat and put tefillin and everything? And the young man screamed, yes, yes, yes. You promise? Yes, yes, yes. So I said to him, okay, so get up. And the boy got up. This is a story that everyone will not believe, and everyone will say that that's just a legend of some kind, a fantasy. But the story goes on, that the young man got up from his chair. He went out from the synagogue of Baba Shale, and he went all the way dancing with his legs to the yeshiva of Yeshivat HaNegev. And all the Talmidim, when they heard him, they started to dance, and the whole yeshiva was dancing. How can you say that this is a fantasy? When it has been testified by Bachurei Yeshiva, the whole yeshiva, and a very serious yeshiva, by the way. I'm telling you, Yeshivat HaNegev is one of the best yeshivot that we have today in this generation. So here is one story of Baba Saleh. There are so many other stories. One of them, my cousin, Rabbi Michael Toledano. God bless him. Rabbi Michael Toledano, the founder of Yeshivat Or Baruch, one of the most splendid yeshivot in the land of Israel. He told me that he had a very big problem when he started to build the yeshiva in Beit Vagan, Yerushalayim. One of the workers was an Arab, and something fell on him, and he was, I think his hand was cut off or something, and now he wants reparations, he wants compensation. He hired a lawyer and everything, and he wants millions. And my cousin tells me, millions? I didn't have anything, even enough to continue the building. How am I going to do? That means the dream of Or Baruch, that story that happened about maybe 4 years ago, 40 years ago. So, what am I going to do? He became desperate, my cousin, Rabbi Michael Toledano. What am I going to do? He has to appear in judgment, in the court, in a few days, with a guy. And what are we going to do? If, for example, he succeeds in that court, finished. The dream of Or Baruch is over. So he said, I must go to Baba Saleh. Maybe he can pray for me. And I'm telling you, Rabbi Michael Toledano is not the type to go easily to somebody to pray for him. He himself is a rabbi, a Talmid Chacham, everything. But he was desperate. So he went all the way to Netivot. The family is Toledano is very known to Baba Saleh, because Baba Saleh owes tremendous gratitude to the family of Toledano. That's why the family of Toledano, they felt very close to him. Because Baba Saleh himself received his smicha from the famed Rabbi Baruch Rafael Toledano. That's the grandfather of the family, our family. So, long time ago, Baba Saleh left Tafilalet in the south of Morocco to come all the way to Meknes, right? And that's where he went to Rabbi Baruch Toledano to ask for his smicha. That is something that is definitely testified. And that's the reason why a man like Rabbi Michael Toledano would definitely enter easily without any limits the house of Baba Saleh. When he arrived to Netivot, Baba Saleh was outside the door. And he saw him coming and he says, Rabbi Michael, come, let's have a seuda. You know, he always had the seuda with his people and everything. Let's sit down and eat and drink. So Rav Michael says, Kibbud Arav, I don't have the time. Just please, just pray for me that Hashem should save me. And I have to go back quickly. So Baba Saleh said, come on, sit down with me. Let's have a nice meal together. Let's drink together. Rav, Kibbud Arav, I have no time. Please, just give me your bracha and bye-bye. Come on, Baba Saleh, come and sit with me. What are you, why do you worry? And Rabbi Michael says, I'm worried, I'm dead worried. He says, don't worry, you're worried. I already took care of him, he said. I already took care of the Arab. Rabbi Michael did not understand. So after he sat down a little with him, he drank a little mahya and everything, and he got his bracha. He said, don't worry, everything will be fine. He went back home and he was told the first thing, that as soon as he arrived to Jerusalem, they told him, you know what happened? The Arab who was attacking you in court passed away. He died. Baruch Hashem, no mishpat, no nothing. Kekenio bedu kol oybecha Hashem. Now let me tell you that I myself had my own personal story. And you know, very quickly, of course, I went to Baba Saleh one day. How? I bought a house in Yerushalayim, in Har Nof. And the Kablan who sold me the house was a man who used to go to Baba Saleh all the time. Was known. So he said to me, when we were after I bought the house and everything, he said, come with me to Baba Saleh. At that time, I was not such a big believer in those things. But then my wife was pregnant, the last time that she was pregnant, the first week, the first 2 weeks, something like this. So I said to him, you know what? Even though I'm not such a great follower, but I'll go with you just first to see the, for the first time Baba Saleh. So it's a good to see a tzaddik. And second, to ask him to pray for me. Maybe I'll have Ben Zakhar. Even though I have my son and my daughter, but I wanted at the end, I wanted to have a boy. So we traveled all the way to Netivot. And we arrived there. There were at least 300 people were sitting outside. But this man, the kablan of my house, he went inside the house. And then he said something. And then suddenly he told me, come in into the house. That's when I saw that the house is beautiful. It was donated by a Syrian Jew. And he said to me, wait here. Well, I was waiting in the in one of the beautiful rooms. And he said to me, soon you will see Baba Saleh. In the meantime, I heard a voice saying that everybody should go home, because, and they were preparing a big seudah. And I didn't know what's going on. They were preparing a big, big seudah. I thought something is happening. Suddenly they asked me to come to see Baba Saleh in his little room, an antechamber, a small chamber in which Baba Saleh was sitting on a very simple, very humble type of bed. And they told me, here is Baba Saleh. I see an old man sitting. I thought, an old man, you know Baba Saleh, you see his pictures and everything. And they told me, sit down. And they prepared the table, and then suddenly all the family came. His wife, Aleha Shalom, and Rabbi Elfasi also sat down. So all, everybody that was there came and sat down on the floor. And they said to me, start singing. Singing? I didn't come to sing. Sing for Baba Saleh. He wants to hear good singing. Singing? So they made me drink, even though I never drink. They made me drink. When I said, I can't drink, I said, don't worry, nothing will happen. Just drink. That's true, by the way. I kept drinking a little, and Baba Saleh himself gave me a cup of arak. And then I was into the mood, and I started to sing. And I was sitting almost on Baba Saleh. I was sitting right near his knees, the same bed. It made me sit there. And I started to sing one song after another, one mawal after another, one mawal after another. And Baba Saleh kept on giving me meatballs and cups of makhia, and I was drinking. And I said, for 5 hours, I think it was at least 5 hours that I didn't stop singing, until it was dark. When it was dark and night and everything, now it's time to go back home. But before, you know what happens, two people came, they helped Baba Saleh to get up. That's how I understood that I saw for the first time that Baba Saleh was quite tall. Well, not like when you see in the picture, you think he's a small man. He's a very tall guy. All the Abu Khatsira family is very tall. And then he put his hands on me, and he blessed me. Long bracha. I didn't understand much, but he gave me all the brachot that you wish. And then he gave me 2 bottles of arak. And then we went back home. We drove back home. When we arrived to Beit Shemesh, midway, I suddenly realized, wait a minute, I said, what have I done? The reason I went to Baba Saleh was so that he can pray for me that my wife should give birth to a boy. But I forgot completely. How is it possible that I went to Baba Saleh and I received all the blessings and yet this disappeared from my mind? You must believe that this has something happened in heaven, that they didn't want me to say it, to remind, to say that to Baba Saleh. Because if I did say it, Baba Saleh would have blessed me, and then there would be a conflict, because in heaven they wanted my daughter to be born. My daughter Urit, may Hashem give her a good shidduch yiratzon.
Amen.
A good zivuk. Zechut Baba Saleh ta'amot. And that's how we went back home, and my wife gave birth to my last daughter. That was the last time I saw Baba Saleh. After a few months, he passed away. He was 94 years old, something like this, and he passed away. So when I told this story, my personal story, with to Baba Baruch, the son of Baba Saleh, he said to me, this is the best story, because it's as real as it is, you could see it. I mean, it's impossible to say that if you take it rationally, it's impossible to forget, because that's the reason why you went to Baba Saleh. And yet, I forgot. So how can you say that there was no intervention from the heavens to make me forget? This way the tzaddik will not be in conflict with what what in heaven have decided already. Anyway, Of course, there are so many other stories. We could tell you stories about Baba Saleh until the end of the time. He was a tzaddik, no question about it. He was a Kabbalist, Baal Kabbalah Gedola. He was a man of tremendous Kedusha. He never looked. He didn't look at a wolf, at least since time immemorial. Many women came to see him. He did not look at any women. He was all the time hiding his eyes, covering his eyes. And his prayers were known to be prayers of a person who is extremely special, extremely devoted to Hashem. A man like this who lived with Kedusha, he sanctified his body. He did not eat much. I heard that he was only ate for 20 years, only a few, a few vegetables, maybe, something. And that's all. So a man like this who has sanctified his body for the service of Hashem, so probably Hashem gave him a tremendous segula, that his prayer is powerful. But besides that, he comes from a family, he's a descendant of a family who has been blessed. It's a family of brachot, his father, his grandfather, all of them. This is a tremendous family who is known by the power of their brachot. I mean, even today, hundreds, thousands of people, they go to Egypt, to the grave in the city of Demenhor, to the grave of Rabbi Yaakov Abu Hatzira. And today in Eretz Israel, when you have the where the grave of Baba Saleh is located, in Netivot, you could see it once a year at least, and every year I went there a few months, 2 months ago when I was in Eretz Israel, and I saw people, religious and non-religious people, coming by the buckets and praying with tears at the grave of Baba Saleh. So, go and decide, is all this true or not? Well, we could see it with your own eyes. This is a man, a tremendous tzaddik, who has given us a certain tradition, that the day of the Hilulah of Baba Saleh becomes a traditional day by thousands and thousands of people. That's the power of a tzaddik, and that's what I can say for now regarding the famed tzaddik Baba Saleh, whose name is Rabbi Israel Abu Hatzira, alav ha-shalom.